Hello there, I am back with new video series. We already started to learn about algae. There is another very well group of cryptogams, that is fungi, and that will be our today's topic of discussion. I want to share an interesting quote on fungi with you. It says, fungi are the interface organisms between life and death, by Paul Stamets. In today's video, we are going to learn about Ascobolus, a very commonly grown fungus around us. I want to request you that we have Facebook page and Instagram official account of Paper Pen Biology. Do follow us for daily facts of life science. Moving forward, let's learn. Before coming to main part of video, we need to learn about the fundamental aspects of fungi. According to Ainsworth and Bisbee, about 40,000 species of fungi are known at present. Although approximately 1 million species seem to be in existence, fungi are cosmopolitan in nature. That is, they are found in soil, water, air, or even in plant and animal bodies. The literal meaning of fungus is mushrooms, and the study of mushrooms, that is fungus, is known as mycology. We could define fungi as nucleated, spore-bearing, achlorophyllous organisms which generally reproduce sexually and asexually, and whose usually filamentous branch somatic structure, which are typically surrounded by cell walls containing cellulose or chitin or both. Based on mode of nutrition, fungi are of two types mainly, saprophytic and parasitic. The fungi growing on dung of herbivores are usually saprophyte, but they are usually called coprophyllous fungi. Ascobolus species is one of these type of fungi, which is going to be our center topic today. This type of fungi have been placed on the subdivision of Ascomycetes, according to John Webster. The classification of Ascobolus belongs to the family Ascobolaceae, or the Pezizalids, subclasses Discomycetes, and the classes Ascomycetes. In this video, we get to know simple workout of fruit body of Ascobolus along with its visible characters under microscope. We need a grease-free glass slide, a pith. I usually cut without using pith, but I suggest you we must try to cut fine sections using pith according to the lab procedures, and the fruit body itself, and a sharp new blade and cotton blue as stain. We are required to hold enough patience to keep cutting the fruit body until you will get a fine thinner section, then staining it with cotton blue, now placing the slide under microscope. First of all, we need to learn about Ascus and Ascospores. The Ascus are mostly elongated, either cylindrical or club-shaped, multicellular, either stalked or sessile structure, containing 4 to 8 ascospores. Asci are generally arranged side by side in a layer known as hymenium. The asci are surrounded by sterile packing, having structures in the form of paraphyses, pseudoparaphyses, and sterile asci, so that asci cannot expand laterally but are forced to elongate. The ascus tip is surrounded by a cup or operculum. In this magnification, it is not visible here. Asci developed in group, and they are surrounded by a common wall of hyphal tissue known as peridium. And the definite structure thus developed is fructification, which is also called ascocarp. In Ascobolus, white formation of asci and ascospores takes place. Some vegetative hyphae grow upwardly, surrounding the sex organs, and form a compact fleshy cup-shaped fruiting body known as apothecium. Asci are projected well beyond the level of the hymenium of the apothecium. Ascospores are globose or elliptical in shape, arranged in a row. Mature ascospores are dark colored. The ascospores are liberated through the apex of asci in large numbers under moist conditions. These spores are scattered by wind over considerable distance. On falling upon a suitable substratum, each germinates by putting forth a germ tube and develops into a new hypha. This is all about today's video. Asexual and sexual reproduction of Ascobolus will be discussed in our upcoming video, so stay with us. I read this book as a reference. You should check it out for better understanding. Please put a comment below for any query or suggestion. Thank you for your patience.